This morning I had a visit from someone who called himself Siddha. He suggested to do this meditation on the subject of facing our fears. When you're ready, sit in a comfortable position and allow yourself to relax. Close your eyes and take a deep breath. As you inhale, visualize white energy, light cascading down right above you as if you're sitting in a shower of light. Feel that light gently tapping your muscles and wherever it takes, wherever it touches your body, it causes you to relax. With each inhale, you breathe in more and more of this light rain, of this powerful energy that allows you to relax. Feel yourself sinking into the ground, relaxing more and more into a comfortable state of relaxation. Any tension, any anxiety dissolve under the tight light tapping of this beautiful white light. Feel the breath expanding in your chest as you draw the energy inside yourself, allowing your organs and tissues to relax. Feel yourself relaxing more and more with each breath you take. Feel your abdomen expanding. Just wait a minute before you exhale it, and then exhale it slowly. Two consecutive deep breaths. And this time when you take a breath, expand the abdomen, hold, release just a bit, and take another deep breath into your solar plexus. Hold, slowly release both areas. Two double breaths again. And as you inhale, expand your abdomen. Hold, release just a tiny bit, expand your solar plexus, hold, release just a tiny bit, and expand the upper chest. Hold, and slowly release all the areas. And as you continue to breathe deeply, notice in front of us a huge orb of brilliant red light. Notice how amazing this light is, rich red hues of all shades pulsating within this orb. And with each breath you take, this orb is growing more and more until it is as big as your body is facing you. Pay attention whether it's dark red or pale red, or perhaps even looking like Bordeaux color. And as you breathe deeply, allow this orb to come close to you and close still until it touches you, and you slowly absorb yourself into that orb, melding together, becoming one with this red pulsating energy. Feel it spreading all inside your body and outside your body. Feel yourself absorbing this red, pulsating, gentle light. It is warm, secure, comfortable, and feels rather like sitting in front of the fire on a cold, wintry day. It makes you feel grounded, yet fully alive, so relaxed, so alive, physically joyous, enjoying your body in every cell, every particle. And as we relax more and more in that light, notice in front of us stands that being that calls himself Siddha. He is very wise. I sense him as male, but it might be that to you she appears as a woman. I believe he will take whatever shape you feel comfortable with, so you will not be distressed in any way. Siddha comes to tell us how to release our fears. Because as we got so comfortable now that we are at one with our body, look within and find that area in your heart, in your chest, in your solar plexus, or even deeper, where you keep all your fears suppressed, unable to express them. Find that dark area in your body that you are drawn to. It might not be where I mention it. Some people may find it in their throat or other areas in their body. Each one of us is individual and unique. Just go with your intuition, with your gut feeling, to wherever you are drawn to, because that's where you're holding your fears, your anxieties, and your stress. And as you identify that area of darkness in your body, come closer. It's like a giant, big pool of solidified, dark, liquid area. Almost like a swimming pool of something dark and gooey and pleasant. Something that you instinctively repelling, persisting to push it away, push it down. And as you continue to observe it, take a deep breath again and intensify that feeling of ugliness, of darkness, of whatever it comes to you from that area in your body. Perhaps you might even need to touch it in your mind's eye to experience the emotion behind it. Do not worry for the feeling that comes from that area. The feeling may be very disturbing. It might bring up back flashbacks, images of past events, or very unpleasant, stressful, terrifying feelings. Just keep focusing on it. Keep raising that energy. Keep intensifying with every breath you take. Remember that you are standing in the presence of Sage, Siddha. You are safe. You are not to come to any harm. You are perfectly safe and secure. Continue to raise the feeling, the intensity of that experience, until it rises like a tornado all around you, until you are swimming in that feeling up to the tips of your hair. Do not contact the feeling personally, just allow it to swim through you, in you, and around you. Do not start getting dialogues, talking to that feeling. Just feel it. Nor do you need to push it away. Allow it to envelop you, flood you all over with that intense negativity, that intense feeling. And as we stand here in the core of that tornado, next to our sage, Siddha, and as we stand there, knowing that this is our darkest feelings, that we've suppressed for so long, the pressure itself can be very distressing. We may feel choking, nauseous, upset. Siddha gives you a huge crystal sword. It is made of red crystal, glowing in that dark feeling. Hold this sword in your hand and feel how the red glows, how you feel supported and loved even though you're in the midst of this awful feeling, awful negativity, huge sweeping energy. And as we stand there holding this sword, Siddha asks you to thrust it forward and pull it with a sharp movement up, as if unzipping the darkness. And then turn it left, a little bit like the harakiri of the Japanese. Thrust it forward, up and to the left. If you don't have enough energy or your hands feel weak, or you feel overwhelmed with that feeling, just do it again. You will know when you've done it right, when the moment you touch the last movement of that darkness, the red sword becomes glowing white. Take a deep breath and thrust forward, up and to the left. Bringing it slightly down. Notice how your sword starts glowing white, even if it's a tiny bit at the end. Carry on doing it with deep breaths, taking a deep breath and thrusting it into the darkness. Do it as many times as you need until the whole of the sword is white, glowing white, of the pure, perfect light. It also gives some kind of satisfaction, I think, to be able to thrust it into the darkness and break it apart. You have the power. You are not a victim. You have the power to relinquish this darkness, to let it go, to dissolve it. You have not given in. Deep breath and one last thrust. And as you do it, notice that the energy around has changed. The darkness has receded, and instead we are surrounded with dark purpley energy, almost indigo in its color. Very powerful energy swirling around us, healing that area of your body, healing you. Deep breath. And as you breathe out, just allow that energy to swirl around you, into you. Some of you may even smell some kind of flowers or herbs, which is also part of this healing process. And while you hold the sword, put the sword facing the sharp end down so that you ground in yourself and release in whatever's left over of the darkest energy, draining into the earth, draining away in a powerful whoosh down, away from you, away from your body. And as you continue to breathe deeply, the energy around you changes yet again. It is now white energy all around you. The soul dissolves, and we are enveloped in white, relaxing and healing, allowing this beautiful white light to heal every element of our being, every cell, every particle are being healed now. And as you relax into that white light, Siddha wants you to breathe in that white light. Breathe it in so deeply that it dissolves all the areas of your body into the light. The dissolves your legs, your torso, your hands, until all you're aware of is your head, your awareness, your consciousness. Now Siddha wants us to look into our brains. As you know, normally our brain are transparent grey in colour, jelly-like substance with little folds and twirls in it. As we look into that area of our body, notice if there are any dark stains, almost like navy blue or even black ink that's almost absorbed in between the crevices in the brain. Find where these areas are. These are the areas that are affected by the negativity of your fears, by the negativity and the fearful energy you were suppressing in your body for a long time. It might be that there's more than one area colored in this deep ink, going deep between the crevices. And so, this time, Siddha brings down a transparent crystal, clear quartz crystal, a big chunk of it, looking like a shape of a pencil. He wants you to touch the areas in your brain that are affected by the darkness. And the moment you will touch, it will hover these areas, so to speak, and drain the brain of the darkness, leaving it pristine and as it should be. Nice and relaxed. So use this crystal to clean the areas in your brain that are affected. And as it slowly does its job, do it thoroughly so no bit will be left out. The moment you relieve certain areas, feel more blood circulation around your body, a feeling of calmness, a relief, and a sense of joy starts permeating your body in certain areas. It is interesting if you notice which areas of your body are affected by the areas you clean in the brain. For example, I can feel some in my legs as well as abdomen. Perhaps you may feel in different areas of your body. Make sure that you leave no dark crevices behind. Keep deep breathing while you cleanse in the areas. Knowing that you bring in yourself joy, health, and a huge release of what you no longer need. Enabling yourself to become who you truly meant to be, who you truly are. When you think you're finished, Siddha will pass a special net above your brain, and it will show you in a special way if you've left any areas or forgotten about something that needs to be cleansed. A little bit like a CT scan. If you have any areas that you've forgotten, come and cleanse them again. When you're ready, allow yourself just to relax and dissolve in that white light still surrounding you, cushioning you so you feel safe, supported, and loved. Notice how much more lighter your body feels, how much more energy flowing in your body, back and forth, as it should be. Some of you may even feel tingling sensations or other ways of unblocking the energy on its different meridians in your body. Please make sure you're drinking plenty of water in the next couple of days and try not to have sugar or caffeine in your diet to help your body release any toxins it's now working so hard to release. When you're ready, feel your body floating gently down, down towards the earth. It's as if we were on a cloud level and our body's gently folding itself down to earth. I see our bodies folding into a yoga position of the meditation, legs folded into each other. So that your knees bend towards the earth and your palms touching each other in prayer position. Feel the energy flowing through your crown down to your dantian, which is a couple of inches below your navel, and out through the middle finger in your palms touching each other. Down through the crown into your navel and out through your palms through the middle finger. With each breath we take, our bodies become warmer, heavier, more and more relaxed in a heavy, physical sort of way. Become aware of the sensations in your legs. Your thighs pressing down on the surface where you're sitting. Your back resting against the chair or the sofa or wherever else you're sitting on. in your own time, open your eyes and come back to your everyday consciousness, feeling calm and energized, ready to see a new day. I will thank Siddha from all of us for this amazing information and wonderful experience. Thank you. And I hope to join in the meditation with you again.